thank you very much for this organization, the Big Things, to let me introduce this an initiative that we consider that is very important, because we consider that it's time to take action in the responsible and ethical use of artificial intelligence. There are like plenty of theory towards the ethics and the responsible use of artificial intelligence, but we consider that it's time to land all these concepts about artificial intelligence and prepare not only companies but also a society in order to seize all the good things, all the advantages of this technology, of artificial intelligence, and leave aside all the risk that also have this technology. So before going to introduce the structure, talking about the structure and the plenty of projects that we have nowadays in OdiseIA, yet some of them important them, but I'm going to share some concepts about the impact of artificial intelligence in society from an ethical and social point of view, in order for you to understand better what is the role of OdiseIA. Okay, we live in a world based in data, in technology, and for many people it is very difficult sometimes to see what are the real risks of all the technology that they are facing every day. Sometimes they have to face different web pages, most of the time, every day. they have to face plenty of web pages in which they maybe have to click into the policy, privacy policy, and, you know, to accept the conditions, and most of them, most of the people, I would say none of them, just read these conditions, and maybe it could be risky for these people, but they just have to keep going because we live in a world that everything goes so fast and people do not stop and start realizing all the real risk that this technology have for them. And of course, in OdiseIA, really believe in the many advantages of technologies and in the many advantages that artificial intelligence has. We really believe that it's very good. It would be very good for society to interiorize and to get different services and products that have these artificial intelligence systems. I really believe that it would be easier their lives, and not only that, but it will bring many good things for their health, or for example, personal treatments for a specific disease, or it will get to have everything better in the trials, or another things like this. But they have to see also, it is very important also to see this bad side of technology, in this case about artificial intelligence, but this technology that we have, these technologies that we have nowadays. We are full of fake news. These fake news are all around us. And for some people, for most of the people, sometimes it is very difficult to see what is fake and what is real. Sometimes they just do not trust in one specific brand, and they just go to the internet, look at some blogs or some networks, social networks, and really they can believe in what is written in these parts. Nowadays, with artificial intelligence, it is even worse because of the deep fakes, which are the use of images, of deep learning to techniques in order to try to do news through videos, or not only news, different images, and put like in the mouth of, for example, some people, some famous people, words that they haven't said. And another thing that is very important are the many plenty of cyber attacks that nowadays are suffering plenty of companies throughout the world, and which is they are like trying to kidnap this data, and there are like a lot of conflict with these cyber hacks attacks. So so there are also plenty of disadvantages on this technology, and then we have another actor in this scene, which is the artificial intelligence, which has specific peculiarities. And it is very interesting to ask this question Because in another technologies that we have before, we didn't have to ask us this question. Why ethics is needed? Really, we are talking, and nowadays we are talking a lot about ethics, even more than when the internet started, even more than 10 or 15 or 20 years ago. Nowadays, we talk a lot about ethics. But the thing is that we also talk a lot about about data ethics. And sometimes we have to stop and think if we don't have to keep talking about data ethics, but stop and start thinking again about human ethics, which nowadays is the most important thing. If we land this technology, we are still in a place in which we have to keep thinking about human ethics, not only this artificial intelligence ethics. So let's try to land this concept and start talking about the peculiarities, the specific things, the specific characteristics of artificial intelligence. We have here different elements. From one side, we have the different prejudices associated with science fiction. This is one peculiarity that did not have another technologies in the past. There are plenty of these prejudices in the mind of plenty of people, not only the civil society, but also in the mind of even people that are like in the at high level in different companies. So it is very important to create consciousness and start all these concepts that are related to artificial intelligence. What is the current situation of artificial intelligence in order to these people to keep aside these prejudices and start thinking about what an artificial intelligence system can do nowadays and what are the advantages that an artificial intelligence system can have nowadays and what are the risks that an artificial intelligence system can have nowadays. And then we have another element, which is the decision making. This is an ability that only had humans until now. Until these artificial intelligence systems. So that make us think about this plus the previous one, but these producers let us think that maybe there is these machines really could get to take autonomous decisions and really overpass this humanity. And then plus the other one, this decision-making one, make us be a little bit afraid of what this technology, this artificial intelligence is bringing to humanity, to ourselves. Okay, but anyway, I wanted to explain you, to let you think about one very important thing about ethics, when we think about this human ethics, before talking about these data ethics. There is a point of view very very interesting that I would like to share with you. There are when you look to something, when you as human are trying to make a decision, sometimes you are influenced by the way you have been rising, like when you were a child and when you are growing up, you have like plenty of influence from your culture, from the country you have lived in, from your family, from many, many places that are really influences. Sometimes, most of the times, the way you decide to make decisions. For example, in the Occident, related to artificial intelligence and these producers that we were talking pre, we have plenty this Occidental world, we have plenty of movies and literature that really bring us the image of robots taking over humanity and that dark side of these robots and artificial intelligence. And that make us think that these robots and artificial intelligence are going to take over this humanity or substitute humans. Nowadays, there are plenty of people that really believe so. This is like almost a fact that this artificial intelligence system will be substituting some specific jobs, but that is almost the same. But it's almost the same that when the internet started, And there were plenty of jobs that were that were disappearing, but there were also plenty of jobs, for example, those of them related to e-commerce that were appearing. So here is going to happen something similar. And then we have these oriental producers in which they have, like, it is quite different because they have been rising with growing. They have been growing these kids with some cartoons in which these robots are heroes and really help humanity. So for them, it's quite different. If you see the reality, what is happening nowadays in China and Japan, you can see, and Japan, you can see how these they are more open-minded when comes to introduce this technology, these robots and this artificial intelligence in their daily life. So then we have the other element about the decision making. As I was saying before, it is very important to see the different points of view when you take a decision. And how I said before, it could be influenced by the culture in which you are, or for example, the family or the beliefs, the specific beliefs in your family. Here you have the typical example about the tram, that if you decide to keep going straight, that do not have brakes, if they decide to keep straight, they will run over these five people, and if you decide to go to this to the other side and just turn, you will kill just one. There are, if you ask somebody, they will say, okay, I will keep. I will really prefer to kill one, but the other. But then, if you say if the one is one member of your family, for example, what would you do? Or if you put another specific element into the scene, maybe they could take a different decision depending on so many different things. So sometimes it's a specific perspective, a different point of view. Okay, but there is one very important thing when that is for a human, or also a human. Sometimes it's different when you talk about a decision. If there is some simple decision or it's just an automatic process that is in your brain and is not like very important, you just make that decision without thinking almost anything. But for example, for doctors, where it's a very complex decision or it has personal or professional implications, very important implications, then you have to think a little bit more, and sometimes you can be influenced by this external influence that I was talking about. And for these artificial intelligence systems, now we jump to this autonomous decision making. It is very important if we get into that point in the future, talking about the autonomous decision making, it is very important that we always have this, we keep talking about ethics of humans. It is very important. That means that human will still be the center of all of this. Not for these automatic decisions that we were talking previously. That is like very normal to use artificial intelligence system for specific automatic things that do not have any implications. But for those decisions which are like very important, that really had an impact in society or in their professional lives, it is very important to maintain the human as a center. And this machine, this artificial intelligence system, will be used to complement the decision of the human. In any case, will be substituting this, in this case, the final decision of the human. And that is very important to take that, because we have context, and that is like very important thing that we use most of the time that we have to take an important decision. The context is important. The machine do not context. So use the machine, this artificial intelligence system, as a help to humans, to make better decisions. But there's a fact, we have to learn to live together with the machines. This is our present, and they will be our future. And for that, it is very important to learn their own language and really come to start learning to live together. For that, there are, as I said before, there are plenty of tries to do these international ethical codes of artificial intelligence. And we also had, for example, European Union, we have a white paper already on the European Commission on Artificial Intelligence, in which they try to increase, for example, to improve the excellence in the European Union towards this topic, increasing investment in artificial intelligence, retaining and promoting researchers and the skill development and create an European Center of Artificial Intelligence. And another very important thing is trust. Okay, they know that it has to be legislation about artificial intelligence, and we should do this legislation, but not a legislation in the whole technology, in the whole artificial intelligence as a whole, but in a specific high risk sectors, like, for example, health, transport, or public administration, or legal, plus another thing, which is very important, the high risk use case or case of use, for example, facial recognition. And then, so it is very important to for this. It was very important this because it's a way to keep improving the development of artificial intelligence and also try to avoid these impulses. So what as I said before, it's important to do a legislation about these cases of abuse in these specific sectors. But this is not only a thing. We have to also to do some things from the civil society side. We talked previously about these multicultural differences and perceptions, so I'm not going to go over it again. But for example, just going to give you an example. If I give classes in the university, and sometimes when I ask my students about what is for them privacy, and they start talking to me a lot about what is happening with them in social networks or these kind of things, for some people in the class do not care a lot about this privacy, and for other people care so, and other people really care a lot about this privacy. So there is not one specific point of view from civil society towards this specific topic. So I think it's important to start creating this individual responsibility. Not only the legislation is okay, but we have to prepare society. We have to prepare society in order to take this individual responsibility. Of course, this has to sum up with the social consciousness and the business consciousness. This is very important. So in order to create this individual responsibility, maybe it's good to give them a lot of information. And there are some things, some research in different places in Europe who are thinking about doing an algorithm labeling. Okay, like you have, for example, in a specific food, when you go to the supermarket, in which you can see different information of a specific product that you are going to consume, maybe it won't be a bad idea to put a specific information into a specific service or product that is run with that has inside an artificial intelligence algorithm. So it would be at the end the responsibility of the consumer to take this product or not, depending on the information they can see in that specific robot, in that specific product or service. So there is if we do that, we really are going to see how people start having more confidence and more trust in these different services and products that they have these technologies. And it is very important to don't forget the consumers. We talk a lot in the scientific world about this, but about this responsibility, about what is the different things about the development of artificial intelligence. But we have one key is to prepare these consumers to get all these products and services. So we have to do many divulgative actions. And we also not us, but the government has to do active policies from this government towards these needs. it is very important to do that. Also, it's very important to have the to develop a critical mind in these people, in these consumers. And okay, the algorithm can tell you what recommend you what to see, for example, in Netflix, but you at the end has the control to decide you have the last word to decide what to see or not. What is it could be obvious what I'm saying, but for a lot of people it's not obvious, and they just get what they see through the screen, and they just feel like they have to watch it in this case, and it's not the case. And it's very important that they understand well what is an artificial intelligence system and what does an artificial intelligence system, and develop this critical mind in society. From the business side, it is very important to have this ethics from design, and also to take care from design, for example, of privacy. We have this BBC box in which in a smart home from this box they can run all the different devices that they have inside of the home without having this data out of their specific home. So it is a very interesting things. And of course, it's very important this, as I said before, the education and awareness to let them know, the people know, that the artificial intelligence is coming to collaborate, not to substitute. And there is another very important thing that I wanted to share with you. It's like not have this please into account, that not because we can do something with this technology, we must do it. We have to keep developing the artificial intelligence systems, but sometimes we have to stop. We will have to stop and think if it's the way that we are going, it is the correct one, or maybe we can take another path in order to go to keep aside unnecessary risk. So we have here then OdiseIA. OdiseIA was created, as I said at the beginning, to land all these concepts and start educating society from one side and creating consciousness also into different companies. The time really is now. We shouldn't wait anymore. So we combine, as our strategy, we combine knowledge and different initiatives. We have created a network of social and international experts. We collaborate with institutions, companies, public and private. And we also, of course, research and try to implement. And we are proactive and an independent, totally independent observatory. And we are very focused in education and in personal advice. And this is an integrated project. We are committed to cross-disciplinary. And also we promote artificial intelligence from its responsible and ethical use. And we are also focusing many projects for social good. There are three types of areas, different challenges. For example, that I will be explaining to you later about this, for example, bias, explicability on privacy. We are divided also in sectors, for example, health, for example, I will talk to you about some of them also. And we have some transversal areas, for example, research, communication, and develop of different tools, ethic that could help to the ethics of artificial intelligence. Here are some of the areas that we already have launched. For example, privacy, inclusive AI, relation, robots, people, liability, bias and discrimination, AI for good. We have different sectors, for example, defense and security, health, public administration, finances, and these transversal areas, ethics and responsibility, education, media outreach, research and communication, and there are plenty of them we are still looking for some experts to launch the rest of the areas. And the last thing I wanted to say is this is like something that anybody knows, so this is the first thing that we talk about, this just the people that are working this initiative. This is the initiative GIA, which is, this is in Spanish, I apologize for this, but we didn't have time to translate it into English, but I will be explaining it to you. Next 27th of November at 9:30, we'll be launching this product, this project. This is like a process, and a specific process. This event will be just the beginning. There will be participating Carmen Artigas, which is the Secretary of State of the Digitalization Inteligencia Artificial, Pilar Manchón, Senior Director of Artificial Intelligence Research Strategy in the global, in Madrid, in the main part of Google. Then we have from Enrique Delgado Samper, which is Chief Technology Officer of IBM. And from Microsoft, we have David Carmona, General Manager of Artificial Intelligence of Innovation. And from Telefonica, we have to Francisco Montalvo, which is the Chief Data Officer of this company. They are going to be explaining in this event, just in 15 minutes each, what are the real strategies in the responsible and ethical use of artificial intelligence. Not something that they are going to be in the future, not general things, but what are the real things that they are doing nowadays when they have a specific case of use, which could be problematic, could have a specific impact. And they are going to be showing us what are the real strategies in the responsible use of artificial intelligence. After that, we will start a period in which we will be analyzing with people of each one of these companies all these strategies in deeply, very deep. And then in February, we will be opening all these processes to people from the different sectors in order for them to come with us to work in this analysis, to give us what are their real cases of use. So we will see, we will be personalizing this guía to each one of the sectors, to the real things that is happening with these companies that are using nowadays these artificial intelligence systems. At the end, there will be like a big analysis about this. And in October, we'll be presenting this guía personalized to every one of the sectors as a guía in the responsible use of artificial intelligence, which we consider that it would be very important. We have the government support, and we think it's going to bring plenty of good things to all of the company in Spain and maybe in also in other countries, because we are really going to land everything into what is happening nowadays. Okay, this is just another thing. The book we brought, Richard Benjamin's and I, just to keep talking about the social, thinking about the social education. For us, is very important. And in this book, we try to transmit to the general public what is the real thing about artificial intelligence and in a very simple language, so everything can understand. Thank you very much. I appreciate very much. Whatever question you have, I will be happy to answer. Thank you.
So thanks so much, Idoia. We have a question here. It's a quite philosophical one. I know you like this philosophical question, so it's a good question for you, for sure. Today, human creation, artificial intelligence, is trapped in the creator, with a human. So how do you think we should deal with this crisis? Where creation is trapping the creator.
Could you repeat the question again, please?
Yeah. The question is that the human creation, artificial intelligence, is trapping. So yes. It's going ahead. It's going beyond. It's going farther yes. than the creators, mm-hmm. We the people. So how we yep. deal in a world where creation go beyond than creator? It's a quite philosophical one.
Yes. Okay. I think I already talked about this in the presentation, but it's a very important question. I really think that we are still in a moment in which we can decide. We can decide. It is a fact that maybe if we leave this technology to keep evolving with all its potential, maybe it could. At the end, if this technology can develop all of its potential, maybe it will happen what this person in the audience is saying. Okay, but I really think I don't know if you remember one of the sentences that I said in the presentation, which is not because you can do it, you should do it. Okay, we are at this, maybe this technology would be able to just take decisions and autonomously, but we are the one that have to decide. Nowadays, it is possible to decide, to make that decisions, okay? And we don't have to generalize, and we should always have this technology by the human hand, okay? You shouldn't keep thinking about this technology taking over humanity, leaving this technology just going farther without the human hand, without taking the hand of the human. Grow this thinking that the human is the center and we have to keep developing this technology, knowing and keeping the human as a center, it would be good. But if we just keep, just because this technology can at the end take decisions by itself, just leave this technology to evolve without any legislation and without any barrier, be a problem for sure. But it's our decision as humans. It is very important to all the time to have in mind that it is nowadays it's our decision as humans to decide in which way we should go.
Okay, Sean, thanks so much. It's the moment for taking decisions, and of course, if we don't take them, probably others will take them. So it's an important moment for all of us. So Idoia, thanks a lot for being with us. I again recommend her book with Richard Benjamin, El Mito del Algoritmo, Algorithm Myth. That for sure you will enjoy, because you have a lot of information about this human side of the artificial intelligence revolution. So Idoia, thanks so much.
Okay, thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
Bye.